of the lost world, still under the ancient sentence of death. And from that extreme of misery, divine providence willed us to rescue us and was pleased to utilize you in that merciful design, assigning to you a part which could not be more noble. So utterly dependent on the Redeemer, you were decreed his helpmate, the brother as near to him as a creature could be, made indispensable to him. We have to realize that it's not enough to just work evangelizing and testifying. What we have an obligation to do is to work in union with Mary and with the power that comes through the Holy Spirit, that comes from her intercession. Of all mankind, you alone were pure enough and strong enough in faith and spirit to become the new Eve, who with the new Adam would reverse the fall. Your prayers, already full of the Holy Spirit, drew Jesus down to earth. Your will and flesh conceived him. Your milk nourished him. Your surpassing love enveloped him and enabled him to grow in age and strength and wisdom. In a real way, you molded him, he who made you. Then, when the hour ordained for the offering had come, you freely gave the divine lamb to his mission and to his sacrificial death on Calvary, enduring with him a plenitude of suffering like unto his own, of such that you would have died along with him, but that you were detained to nurse the infant church. Having thus been his inseparable helper throughout the accomplishing of redemption, you have been no less with him, no less necessary to him in the Christian dispensation. Your maternity expanded to receive all those for whom he died. And you, Mother of mankind, as you mothered him because we are in him, each soul remains committed to your patient care. And until at last, you give it birth to life eternal. Finally, as it was willed for the completeness of the plan of salvation that you should be instrumental in every part of it, so was it required that you included in our worship. We must appreciate what you have done, and through our faith, our love, our service, attempt an adequate acknowledgement. Having thus declared the vast extent and sweetness of our life, I now debt to you, what more is there to say but to repeat all with all our hearts that we are yours, our queen, our mother, and all that we have is yours. Amen.
Amen. Amen.